This is the spaghettiest puzzle. This is spaghetti. All right, this is Stuck Dog Puzzle by Sir Schlecht. Let's go. Please help dog. Doggy stuck. Dog fetch. Stolen tools. Dog promise. Oh, world record by Dan the Tanks. I think Dan really liked this one. Love your username on the dog. All right. That is the dog. Is dog helpful or is dog friend or not friend? I mean, dog stole tools. But dog also want to play fetch, so dog bring tools back? Oh, look at that. There's a little off-screen dog. Wait, come back. Come back. Yeah, there he is. Aw. Okay. Oh, good music, though. Yeah. Do-do-do-do-do. Yeah. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. This is one of the first songs I ever learned how to play on piano. I don't know why. I love this song as a kid. All right, what do we have in the level? What are we doing? What are we doing? Okay, we need to eventually go in this door right here. And it says that there's a snowball. You can't see it now, but there's a snowball in this block right there. So we can keep that in mind. It looks like there's a bomb that's gonna come out of here, which would blow this up and hit the on and off switch. But we need to get the key from killing Chomperson, I think, to go in the door. Okay. There's also this on and off switch here. I don't know how I'm gonna hit that. Oh, there's another. Okay, so something can go, if you check this out, something can go across the top of the map and hit this block. And that would actually release another bomb that would hit this on and off switch. Oh, wait, the key is from this. Wait, the key is from the red coin and not from the chomp. What's the point of the chomp then? Is there a point of the chomp? Okay, and I think we're not gonna go back in this door. That's where we came from, right? Chomp is dog to chomp. Chomp friend. Okay, maybe chomp is friend. Red coin for key, don't murder doggo. Maybe we don't have to murder doggo. Okay, well, we have stumps again. We also have another mushroom. How? So the key is interesting because you can just go over here and get this, but you can't get out. So we're gonna have to like remote collect that. I think with the snowball, I think the plan is we're gonna have to throw a snowball in there at some point and collect the key. What can we actually accomplish then? I mean, we can go, hold on, we can go over here. Do-do. Oh, if I go up here, it's GG. Okay, if I go up here, there's no getting back. So that hits that. But we need... I think the chomp will hit that. Actually, I have an idea. If I free the chomp, because I think this level was inspired by Steve-O's level. If I were to free the chomp... Look at that. Now it hits the on and off switch. Yeah, look at that. So we can free chomp. We can free chomp. Chomp goes away and hits the on and off switch. Now we can get back down here, which might be good. There's like a boo thing stopping me from going through here without getting hit. There's nowhere for me to grab a snowball. Oh, could I have grabbed a snowball? It's too late now, but I think I could have grabbed a snowball up there. Ooh, shiny elevator button. Let's go. I think that we are out of options for now. Okay. Okay, here's my plan. First step, free champ. Second step, get snowball. Actually. Second step, retrieve that. Third step, get snowball. Is there anything I can hit from here with the snowball? Or could I hit from here if I had like positioned correctly? I don't think so. But this is going to let me get another snowball, right? That lets me get another snowball. Oh, that would let me, if I could. Oh, I just realized the launcher gets destroyed, by the way. Interesting, the launcher is gone and now we've lost the mushroom. I feel like that's gonna be important. But if the mushroom were to have like traveled into this room, I could get hit, recollect the mushroom, and then stand on that snowball and go through the door while I'm SMB2 Mushroom. I feel like that might come in handy later on. I also want to know, I want to know what the blue platform does. Is it possible? I should be able to avoid using the blue platform by doing something like this. I need to look at... Oh, no, I need one of these to free... Yeah. Okay, this is good. Now I can save... Hold on. What exactly happens here? Let me look carefully. Why does the mushroom die? Oh, the mushroom goes down the pit right there. I see. That's why that pit's there. I see. So I need to save that somehow. Maybe with the stump. But then I do have to use the blue platform to go up there. Yeah, I think I do use this blue platform. Woo! That went right down there. All right, wait, I've got ideas. Okay, so let's put this here because that will save the mushroom. And then let's come up here. Let's use the blue platform to free the champ. The chump. The chomp. Okay. Let's not throw this down the pit, though. Don't throw down pit. Oh, don't do it. Okay, grab a snowball. Okay, look at this. So now we have things. We have things at our disposal. I can go up here. Look at this. Easy game. Now we've got a key. Now we have a key. And... Oh, this is not going to help the mushroom go past that, though. I can't actually get the mushroom, like, unless I hit the switch again, which maybe I do hit the switch again. Okay, so on the screen, if you notice right here, clearly there is a way for me to activate this, which I think must mean that I take this snowball and hit that with it. Is there any other way to activate that block? You're stumped. All right, what are my options here? Let's say there's some magical way for me to get this mushroom in here. Because I've thrown the snowball here, I'm kind of in a pickle because I don't have a snowball to get this snowball with. Oh, if this blows up, I can go in and out of here freely. This isn't right. Instead of throwing that there, I have to throw the snowball here, and then I have to use that snowball here, and then that blows open this area, and then I am free. I don't know where I'm gonna get another snowball, though. Unless I get another snowball here, but I can't get back anymore if I do that. Can I? Or wait, where does this blow up exactly? I think we have to change the order a little bit. Alright, is there anything to be gained from putting this up here? I don't think so, because I need it. That destroys that. Oh, but that lets me... Ooh! That is spicy! I think I might... Oh, but maybe that's de-cheesed. This is a very ambiguous prediction. Yes, indeed. I think that... Wait, can I... No, I can't, like, suck up the mushroom. I think that I want this in my life. What if we do this? And this. Can I re-grab this? Oh, yeah. Oh, that's... goes right there. Stop it. Here, let's put that one there. Let's put this one here. And put this one there. Put this one there. Yeah. All right. Now we can sort of herd this. We can herd the mushroom. Someone definitely needs to make a herding mushroom anti-softlock. Wait, why was I doing that when I could? Oh, dear. All right. Well, now we can save the blue platform, right? No, we still can't save the blue platform. Yeah, we still can't save the blue platform. Did that even accomplish anything? I'm not sure that accomplished anything. Well, we can do this. We can do... Ooh-ah! Oh. Yeah. Ooh-ah! All right. No, don't go in the pit. Okay. Snowy ball. Okay, now that that mushroom is in there, we can do this and we can acquire mushroom in there, which I think is very important. So let's go in here and then re-mushroom. And then we're gonna ball. And then we're gonna bonk. And then we're gonna boom. And now we have free entry. Look at this. This is the key. We have free entry between this place and that place. So we can simply put a stump over there, for instance. And that would let us go in the door. This is good. We straight ballin'. All right, but we need more snow. I think we can get more snow, but then we can't get back. Like, if I go up there again, I can't come back home, I don't think. Is this for a purpose? This is interesting. This block feels like it's nothing, but like, what if? What if? Somehow. Breakable block. How breakable is this block, though? How breakable is this block? Where can we acquire another snowball? That's the key right now. It's like, how do we get another snowball? I can't go in this, can I? I don't think I can. Yeah, I can't go in this door again. It's like close though. I mean, I think you can cheese your way into this door. Yeah, you could like, you could Kaizo cheese into that door, I think. All right, I think we're boninated. But we're gonna go check just in case. I mean, look, we can still get up here again. I don't think I can use a stump to collect that coin. I think I need a snowball. So in what way could we obtain another snowball? I mean, I can just walk over here and grab one. But now, without a means to get back down, we're boned. All right, I think we're dead. But this was good progress. What will this do? Well, the problem is the stump. But once that's in there, will this stop this? Will this allow me to? Oh, unlimited snowy balls. Unlimited. Not quite unlimited, but more than... Wait, what? How come I didn't do it that time? That trajectory, though. Wait, what? I got the god throw. All right, there we go. Extra snow. That's where the extra snowball comes from. I like this puzzle a lot too, Funk. I'm having a really good time with it. Okay, so now... I restart because I'm an idiot. Because I'm an absolute idiot, I restart the puzzle. Yeah, that like de-escalated quickly. We go from unlimited snowball to one snowball to I fucked it all up. Okay, first step, free the chomp. Chomp hits the bomb. Okay, second step, acquire snowy ball. Snowy ball allows us to save the snowball on the conveyor, which I really like that. That's really cool. But then the key here is we put the stump back and then we get another snowball. So we come down here with yet another snowball. Use one snowball to get the other snowball over there, which we have to do because we get hit right there, which would cause us to drop a snowball. So we can't like carry a snowball into here. But we can come in here and get that snowball now. Use it on that block. Freedom. Then we can take a hot second for a little elevator button. Wait, where did my snowball go? Quite limited snowballs. I changed the direction of the conveyor. So, if I were to touch these dudes, these ghosty boys, with the ball, I would drop the ball and break it. So, I have to first use the ball, and then re-get the mushroom over here, which allows me to re-grab it. And I've once again fucked up. So, we're gonna restart the level. You can tell I'm used to being a teacher, though, because I'm used to talking like I know what I'm talking about when I don't know what I'm talking about. Kappa. All right, is that gonna hit? Oh my God, I think I have stumped myself. Okay, stumping. Oh, you. What is going on right now? This is such a spaghetti-filled level. Jesus. What is going, stop it! Okay, that needs, immediately lift this and put it into a troll level. Immediately lift this and put it into a troll level. All right, see that snowball stays there. Oh my God. All right, this here, we need to use one of these. Well, hold on. Let's hit, oh, if this, put it here. Fuck. Okay, get the next one down here. Probably go up here. Wait, where did the snowball? What happened? Oh my God, what happened? Where did it go? I didn't see what happened. Where did it even go? Did I throw two? Oh my God, I don't remember throwing the second one. What am I doing? Oh, this is the spaghettiest puzzle. This is spaghetti. Do two of them. Okay, here's the plan. First, we do this. Whew. At least that doesn't break. Okay, I think I can actually grab this. Yeah, that's nice, that's nifty. Okay, now we can do this. Now, why can't I just beat the level, by the way? I don't understand why I even have, this is why I got confused. What's the point of the, uh-oh. No, that's okay. I don't understand why I can't just beat this level. No mushroom. Betrayal! Betrayal! Dog betrayal! Betrayal! Will I beat the puzzle on this life? This life. If I restart, it's over. If I restart, it's over. Do. Did I already fuck it up? No. All in on no. Look, Clutch Sagan makes an appearance every now and then, alright? What was that? Did you see that? It hit the freaking, oh my God, that snowball is trolly. Okay. Do. What am I gonna get hit on? That's the question that I have. What am I gonna get hit on? The booze. Am I gonna get hit on the booze? If I put that in there, how am I gonna get hit on the booze though? How am I gonna get hit on the booze? Do I want this in there, or does it not matter? I'll just go get it out here once I break that, right? Okay. I think we're good. We're just gonna do this. Do I want to get hit? No, I can't get hit yet. Yeah, how am I gonna get hit? I think we're dead. Something's wrong. No, I need the shroom because I need to put these here. Can I get hit on the stump? Can I get crunch? How can I crunch? Is there some way to crunch? How do I crunch? How do I booze? How do I get hit by booze? What else can hit me? What else can hit me? What else could potentially hit me? I mean, I could have gotten hit on this explosion, but that's not enough, right? Because it says no. I could get hit on this explosion, but then I can't carry these stumps. Even if I get hit on these, I can't get back from the stump, from the spike, can I? Can I get back from the spike? No, there's no way to get back from the spike. There is a way to get hit. There is a way to get hit by a stump. Now this one has to stay here or else I can't get in there. It is possible to get hit by a stump. But I think maybe not from where I'm at. Yeah, if I throw that up there, I'm not getting it back. This is cheese. It does, stumps can hit you if they move, but I think nothing here can make them move. Okay, so what could we have done differently? I don't quite understand how we could do this in a different order or something. How could we do this in a different order? It'd be dumb if it was a red herring. You don't need to hit the on and off switch. What does that on and off switch do for us? Oh, I can go back up. I can go back up, but then I can't get back down. It doesn't really help. Okay, so a stump can damage you if something else makes it move up and down. Because we got killed by a stump in Steve-O's level. So if it's not the booze I get hit by, the other thing that can damage us. What's that door right there? What the heck is that other door right there, by the way? But look at this, watch this. Well, what's the right way to do this, actually? Oh, yeah. This is probably it. Yeah, that's it. All right, that's it right there. That's the strat. That's the good stuff right there. That is the good stuff right there. So now, we need to find a way to not use the platform, which is very non-trivial right now, I feel like. Because I'm in need of that platform. So how is this going to work out? Oh, I know how to do it. No, I don't know how to do it. Do I know how to do it? Oh, I know how to do it. I'm an idiot. Fuck you! Okay, hold on. We're gonna let this come out. Let this go there. We just need this, like, here. Wait, why didn't I do this? I swear I tried this, and then I don't know why I abandoned that idea, but I think I got confused somewhere in there. I already did that earlier. Okay. No. Stop. Okay, there it is. No, that's funny. You even throw it in the right position. It's pretty great. Okay, so that one can go there. Betrayal! I think it's funny that like goes right into position. That's actually awesome. So this one can go there. I just about did it again. That one goes there. That's so cool that the stump is already in position. Okay. That's so smart. That is so smart that the stump goes where it needs to go. Like, that's such good level design. That's the like little cherry on top that I feel like takes a level, like, okay, this is something that, like, people talk about or complain about puzzles all the time, which is that, like, oh, it uses super obscure tech that I have to, you know, figure out, and if I don't know this weird, obscure glitch tech, then I'll never be able to solve the puzzle. Like, shit like this is how you teach somebody a cool mechanic without it being obscure. And I really like that level design decision. Do I need the stump? I just go get the stump later, right? I go in there, I get out, I put the stump in and then I get hit. Yeah, I think we're fine. So I can just go in here. I can just go in here, get the snowy ball, do that. Very good, Akiva. Okay, we could just go over here and just put that there. And then, am I forgetting anything? You just get hit, right? Nice. Now we hold right, GG. This is so cool, really, really cool puzzle. No more betrayal, please. Thanks. Boop, 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 boop. Okay. Ooh, more balls up here. Can I touch the balls? No. Can't touch the balls. What does it say? Gameplay. What does it say? Wait, what is. What does this say? Grackpack? Oh, it's Grackpack? That's, Grackpack. That's, Grakowski's, like, little Discord thing or whatever. Snowball. 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 Aw. GG! That was a fantastic puzzle. I really liked that one. Amazing level. Schlecht, I loved it. Fantastic. Good stuff. I think it was really cool how that puzzle was clearly inspired by Steve-O's. Like, you know, some people I think will often say, like, you know, oh, how do I come up with a brand new idea all on my own? And I feel like that level was the perfect example of how you take something that you saw somebody else do and you put your own spin on it in a way that is totally original and fresh. Like, yeah, I don't think you can possibly fault that level for being similar to Steve-O's. It was totally different, but it was based on some of the same ideas. Really good, really good. Love the plot twist of Dog Betrayal. Me too. It was a good level. Spike Stole Your Tools by Major. Let's do it. Snowball Effect. I like the pixel art quite a lot. Very nice pixel art. Let's do. It almost lined up with the song for a second. Horrifying. Hello, Spike. Did you steal my tools? Ooh, Spike puzzle, though. This is cool. Ooh, I can get snowballs. Wait, I can get unlimited balls. Wait, this is everything I've always wanted. Unlimited snowballs. Let's go. Oh, it only gives me two. That's interesting. So we can use one of them to hit this swatch. And now we get more. What does this do? What's the point of that? What's the point of that? Huh, if one were to remotely activate an on and off switch, then this would do a thing. How can I remotely activate this? What's like the slowest I can kick? Oh, geez. Did I just want to? I just accidentally killed that piranha. Did I want? I wanted to. Oh my God, we're solving the puzzle and we don't even know how. Let's go, dude. I mean, calculated. Cool, that's really cool. All right, I mean, oh, can I not make, oh, can I really not make that? Can I like midair snowball up there, please? Thank you. Can I really not make this? Huh, I think I have to do that second or something, cause now I'm boned, right? Oh wait, what's this door? Let's see what's in the door. Oh, we restart now. But did that help me? Like, did that do anything? I can do that. That looks tasty. That looks tasty. Hmm. This is interesting. I really like this level because it's very non-standard. So I think we want to start off by hitting this switch to have that activated. And then I think we want to get a snowball. And I think we might just do that. Oh, I messed it up. Let's see what happens. What is this GG? Why is this here? Why is this here? Oh, how come it doesn't keep... Didn't it keep hitting it before? I think I got confused. Or does it only hit it once? After I hit it. Is this going to have something to do with this other on and off switch? Do I need like another snowball? I feel like some chain reaction business is gonna go on here. I shouldn't have this ball, but what's the point? What's the normal switch state? This lets me go through the door at the other switch state. The switch automatically resets. What's the point? I have to hit three on and off switches to get through here. So I need to like basically construct an infinite on and off hitter or something. Or find a way to hit it three times, right? What happens here? Let me experiment with this again. So this hits once. That hits once. Wait, if I don't hold one, does it hit twice? Ah, it's infinite if I don't hold one. Okay. It's infinite if I don't hold one. I feel like I missed that. Okay. Oh, but hitting that one makes it fail. I see. Bouncing off of that one makes it fail. Weird. And so that's why I need to get that other one. I need to go through the door with the other one, but I can't go through the door with the other one. Can I go through the door with this one or no? Does this one break immediately? Breaks immediately though. So how can I use that one? This is so interesting. Yeah, it's gone. I thought that was it, but it's gone. This is like so close to working and then doesn't quite work. Because I can't make the infinite thing and then get up there. So here's the problem. The problem is if I make the infinite snowball machine like this, then I can't get up there. Now I can't get up there. See, look, I can't make this jump. And anyway, even if I could, when I bounce on one of these, it doesn't work. So I need to... If I had a snowball that the other one would crash into and destroy, if I had this extra snowball, how do I get up there? This is probably wrong, but can you do this? I can't, like, go through that switch, that on and off switch, can I? Alright, well, GG. You can't go through that, right? If I get one of these, if I get one of those, and then I, no, it didn't hit it. Could it have hit it, though? No, look, it never hits. So even if it falls on another snowball, it doesn't hit. So how am I going to get up there? I think I might have another idea. What's the point of this? And the switch. If I hit this switch, I could destroy a snowball, but I don't see how to really do that effectively. What can I do? They can hit me all dumb. This contest is really cool. Yeah, I thought if you drop it from above it, I think if I kick it into one, it will destroy it. Here, let's test. Let's do some testing real quick. Okay, if I get another snowball, yeah, if I'm the one who drops it, it will blow up. So I could put one there, have a third one from over there? Yeah, I could. But how do I hit him then? It still doesn't make sense to me. Because I need to hit the piranha still. What am I doing? Is our goal the door? Presumably the door, the goal is the top door. I think I have to do it like this. I think this guy has to be down here. And we need to learn what to do from there. And then this allows us to get this other one. So I think what we have to do is we have to find something to do with this extra one here. What is the plan with this extra ball? Because now we can have three snowballs. But what is the point of having three snowballs? What does having three snowballs do for us? To make a snowman? Okay, so this remakes the infinite contraption. So while this is going on, we have an infinite on and off switch. All we have to do in this situation is be at the top of the screen somehow. We just have to get up there. But the problem is that we can't get up there anymore. Yeah, we need to get the third ball without killing the piranha. That is absolutely what it sounds like we need to do. Because if this were happening, I just can't get up there. Well, it's not just that, right? I can't make the infinite contraption work either. What is the point of this seesaw up here? And why is there an on and off switch right here? I hate how easy this puzzle looks, and it's like freaking tricky. It's cool. It's really cool. I was thinking if you could use the seesaw to slowly roll the ball. Let's try it. I tried it once, and I got this idea, but it's not, it's not easy to do. Or there's an easy way to do it, maybe? I don't know. There's some way to get like a really slow roll. What's like the slowest roll you can get? Fucking hell. Oh, maybe that. Yo, okay. That's good. That lets us get up here. Then that would make the infinite contraption. But we still need to get the other ball. Okay, so I think the first step is extract the third ball. Go up here. Use the third ball? No, the third ball. It's still not gonna work. Because I have to bounce on a ball. If I bounce on a ball. Oh, that's why the on and off switch is up there. See, here's the issue. Let me show you the issue. The issue is if I don't take a third ball up there. Look, I have a ball stuck down there. A stuck ball. Cool. So, look at this. It's gonna throw one, but because the other one is stuck down there, that's all it's ever gonna do. It's not gonna do anything else ever again. Yeah, so that's why I need the third ball. So let's figure out how to get the third ball without just throw the balls up. Yeah, easy. Easy. So, okay. So let's try to get the other one. How can I roll a ball slowly? Is there another way to roll a ball slow? Fuck. Oh, maybe we just do it like that? Maybe that's slow enough. That's slow enough, isn't it? Oh, that's slow enough, isn't it? Oh, but that doesn't work. Ah, I can't have already hit the piranha. Yeah, I can't have already hit the piranha. I can't get this ball and do anything with it like this. I can't do anything like this. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. What if a snowball hits you, don't regrab it? Yeah, that's what I just tried. Alright, so that's not the solution. Uses the roll of the seesaw. The seesaw lets me slow roll a ball down to kill this piranha, which lowers this guy, which gets everything in position. Okay, what am I missing? What I need to do, so here's the problem. The fundamental problem for people who don't understand is I can only make this jump if I haven't destroyed this thing. Once I've destroyed this, I cannot make this jump anymore. I think a lot of people are not understanding that. So I need to find a way to do that, and it all looks so simple, but I can't do it. Does this help me do anything? What if I roll it from here? Will it roll slower? No, it does not roll slower. What if I roll it slower though? What if I put it here and then touch it? It does not really roll slower. I can't get there fast enough. Yeah, that's not it. I think it'll just fall if it's on this and then it gets hit. What if it hits me like that? It's like almost slow enough, but it's really not, honestly. What happens if you kill the piranha? It's really nifty. It allows me to do all the things that I want to do, except the thing that lets me win. See, I can go get this snowball like this, but now I can't get up. Now I can't get up here. That's why I can't do this. Unless there's some other way to get up there that I don't understand. Yeah, we understand the point of the seesaw. We understand the point of the seesaw already. Does P-Speed actually jump higher? No. I need a hint. We might need a hint soon. I don't know. It looks so simple, yet I can't figure it out for some reason. I think there must be a reason you can hit the on and off switch from both sides. Yeah, I was thinking that too, but I think I need the third ball up there to do it, maybe? Like, I'm imagining, like, something... Oh, I don't even know. I don't know. I might need a hint. I've got nothing, y'all. Anyone have any ideas? I've got nothing. Oh! Toto, is that the... Oh, my God! That is crazy. Okay, so what Toto said is... Toto's hint is a really interesting hint. Their hint is despawning the third snowball isn't bad. Is that really the hint? Hold on. Because then, will the spike throw an extra one? So it's not to do with how many spike can throw. Oh, that is crazy. What? Okay, so it's actually, you're supposed to go through this and break it. Now that I can get three snowballs? No, that's not it. No, that's not it. That wasn't it. And on this fine day, we have learned why the person in chat spamming, "Oh my God, Carl, just do this," was wrong the entire time. Oh, that would be cool, but yeah, that sounded so cromulent, didn't it? God damn it. That sounded so cromulent. Do it without stopping them. How do I bounce off a snowball without stopping it? How do I bounce off a snowball without stopping it? Or how do I get up here without bouncing on a snowball? What if I hit it from below? Nope. Nope. Chat has all the answers. Sometimes they're even the correct one. Get scanned. This is hard! I don't get what else to do. It's hard because there's not very many things to do. To get the third ball, shouldn't you try to hit the upper switch? Oh, I'm a fucking idiot. That's why that switch is there. Wait a minute, that's why that switch is there. So, I mean, it's still... Can you not take a snowball to the middle right where the on-off is blue, throw the ball to the on-off and sneak it? See, that's what I'm trying to do right now. It doesn't look like it. Maybe there's a way to slow hit it, though. What if I pulled down? No, I didn't do it. No, I definitely can't. That's not it. But is there some way to slow roll this shit? Is there a way to do it from the top? Wait. Is there a way to do it from the top and go all the way around? That'd be so random. The first step is the hardest to find. Okay, interesting. What if it's like, what if it's like... No, I got no idea, dude. Nothing makes any sense. Just trying shit at this point. What if it's this? It's not that. What is this freaking on and off? Kill the piranha plant? Yeah, that helps us. That helps us get the ball, but then we can't use the ball to do anything. It feels like that slope up there is for a reason, but... Can you enter bottom door from the top of a snowball? Yes, but only with SMB2. So I don't have the costume to do that. Okay, what? This is just gonna, I mean, that's gonna just slowly roll into it, but it's like not enough time for us to do anything with it. We need to like change, maybe we need to change our way of thinking or something? I don't know. Maybe the seesaw is, I mean, maybe the seesaw is used twice. Maybe there's a way to... I got nothing, y'all. I wanted to roll back, but I don't understand how. Yeah, I think we need a hint. Unless anybody else has ideas, we've been here forever. I think we need a hint. I'm getting nowhere. I don't know if it's mechanics that I don't understand or if we're just missing something obvious. Snowball on top of the on and off switch. You're right, it hasn't been tried. What the heck does this do? Here, let's... Get another one. Have you ever played pinball? I didn't... I like the idea, but... It looks like not. Shoot. You need the top switch. Try to find an interaction between on and off, slope, and snowball. Damn it, that's what I tried, but I didn't get anywhere. Maybe it's a slide? I have not used a slide yet. Wait, I haven't used a slide yet? Maybe it's slide? Is it slide? Wait, you saw that already, Major, right? You saw that I already... Yeah, it's not that. You're really close. What the heck? Okay, interesting. Wait. I think I have an idea of how I can help. Okay, I thought about again what we need to do. So what we need to actually do is we need to be right here when a switch gets activated. Oh, I get it. I get what we do. Yeah, I get it. So what we need to do is we need to be right here when the switch gets activated. That's like the whole goal, is just be right here while a switch gets remotely, slowly, later activated. So what we need to do is we need to position the snowball here and then go around and then hit it, such that hitting this block... It's not like this, though. It's not like this, but this is almost the idea. That is gonna make that ball do something, which will then roll down and get hit. That's what we're gonna do, for sure. So we just need to find the spot that will make that happen. That's what we need to do. Okay, I get what we do. We have to put this in a spot where hitting that will make that happen. Maybe it's that. Where would I put it so that that will work? Okay, I see. Whew, that's tricky. So do I want it to be... It has to be touching the on and off block. Oh, it just has to be next. Okay, it's really cool. What I would do to make this puzzle a little bit easier for people, because that is kind of complicated. It's really cool. It's not hard to actually do. What I would do is in some way incorporate either something in the first screen or somewhere in this screen. All you have to do is make part of the puzzle or just make it shown somewhere, like hitting a switch pops up a snowball. I think all you need is a small hint like that, because even if you know that hitting the switch pops up a snowball, it's not trivial to do this. So I think you need to just give people that, and then it would actually, like, I think a lot more people would probably enjoy the puzzle without getting super fucking stuck. But it's a really cool trick. Who needs hints? It's still a really cool trick. Okay, now we have to actually solve the puzzle. Let's see if we have all the pieces to do it now. First off, which switch state do we want? I'm not even sure. In before this still doesn't work, by the way. I think we need to change the switch state still. Let's put that there. I think we want the switch state like this, maybe. And then, or do I want to change the switch state with this third one? I don't know. I don't think so. Oh no, do I? See, one of the problems is that ball down there is still gonna fuck me, isn't it? Isn't that ball down there still gonna fuck me? So I can roll this down and kill the piranha. Where do I want the third ball? I think this is wrong, but I don't know why. Do I want this? I wish I could destroy the ball down there, unless I don't understand why I need to do that. I mean, I technically, will this, hold on. I need to know if this will break. It does. Oh, that's all I needed to do. Okay. Yeah, that's, okay, that's exactly what I needed to do. And now this will go here. I love how, oh no, the seesaw wasn't used twice. Okay. Okay. And that breaks that, and now we've created the infinite. Oh my god, this puzzle is so complex, Major. Jesus Christ. This puzzle is so complex. This was really hard, but it was really cool. It was very, very non-standard, which I really liked. Yo, GG. GG. Honestly, that was one of the coolest, like, just for how original it was, that puzzle was awesome. I think it would have been like a better overall experience for more players if it were just a little easier to discover the tech. And I wanna rant about this one more time, because YouTube does not fucking understand this. All right, get over here, YouTube, sit down. That you can have creative tech in a level, and you can either have it presented in a way that makes it easy to discover, or you can have it presented in a way that makes it hard to discover, okay? And like, for instance, both Tempest level and Dan the Tank's level had creative tech, but they led you to it. I would even say that Steve-O's did as well. Like, knowing that, you know, a chomp is going to break free from the stump or whatever is like not necessarily obvious if you throw it at it with an SMBD thing. But the levels can set it up in a way that helps. The issue that made this middle part hard, but isn't that spoon feeding? No. This is the problem with YouTube, right? It's like, oh, it's either 100 or zero. Fucking no. You can handhold somebody a little. You can handhold them a little more. You can handhold them a lot. You can tell them the solution. You can do nothing. It's a fucking grayscale. And in the middle of that grayscale is where you might want to shoot for. I don't know. So this part up here is hard because you can imagine hitting the switch from a fucking million different ways. You can be on this side, okay? You can have it down here and you can chase it and try to get this one slow. Like, you don't know, are you hitting this one or are you hitting this one? You have a lot of branching paths, okay? And so, you must feel special. I'm mad, all right. But the fact that the seesaw is on top of it makes it harder to discover this tech, which doesn't do this anything with the seesaw, because the seesaw is unrelated to this, to discovering this tech. Yeah, so Tempest Funk, I think, has it exactly. The best levels are the ones that make the player feel smart. Hand-holding is good if it leaves the player with a positive experience. So it's just a balance. Like, you don't want to make it too easy, but you don't want to make it too hard. That's how difficulty works, okay? There's a balance there. For me personally, I think that this part was slightly too hard, but it could be made easier if either this was in isolation, which is one of the problems with the one-screen puzzle. You can't always isolate stuff. Or if there was another part of the level that used a snowball or something else. You could even make it something else popping up off of something. If you use something like that that gets the player thinking in that direction without telling them, that's a way to give people a cool hint without actually telling them the answer. I know, Commander, I'm just, you know, I'm lumping all YouTube together and I'm joking. I don't actually think that everybody on YouTube thinks exactly the same thing. Anyway, cool puzzles. With all the items gone, how will you stop this endless army? By Neonask, another completely new maker to me. Let's do it. Let's do it. Doo-doo, SMB2. Oh, we got claws though. I'm a big fan of claws. So we do have a victory condition. Reach the goal of Super Mario. Does this count as the victory condition? Do I have... Hold on, wait. No, it doesn't. That's actually really interesting. So you can actually be overpowered up and be unable to beat a level. That's actually really interesting. Really quick question that I have before... Yeah, let me move this. So, you see there's a claw on the top left. If I go stand here... Now, if I hit this, will... Oh, the mushroom is stuck down there. Will this... I have to check real quick. Will that go into the claw? No, I was hoping that would go into the claw. That's weird then. What's the claw going to be used for? That's very bizarre. What's the point of the claw then? Huh. Well, anyway. My guess for how to beat the level is this stump needs to go down here and we go in that door? Is that it? This one looks very simple. Let's check and see where the doors go. I think they just go to each other to reset. Yeah. Okay, and like this blows up real fast. Huh. We spawn Mecha Koopas here, so we can always spawn more Mecha Koopas out of this, which is interesting. What do we do? Oh, I can go in this pipe. What the heck? Reset. Okay, that's our reset. There's a lot of reset. Well, I guess we're going up here. If it's SMB1, I can't pick up the Mecha Koopa. What will hitting this do? That lowers that. Can go up here. Oh, this does take me back here, but that's not helpful because it just resets the room. This is so interesting because there's almost nothing happening in this puzzle. There's very few things that you can interact with at all. And yet we can win somehow. Like, what does the claw do? What does the Mecha Koopa do? I can get hit. Do I want to be hit? I can be small even. Do I want to be small? If I hit, this is so bizarre. What a bizarre puzzle. I guess we have snowballs. Wait, I can just... Can I go in the door on the snowball? I guess you can't, like, really make it, can I? Boop! Oh, okay. Alright. That was kind of a sick trick, though, wasn't it? I like that. I like that. So what else can we do with a snowball? We can hit the on and off switch. We can murderize. Is murdering in our best interest? Like it always is, right? It's always a good idea to murder. Would this, if I like somehow get the mushroom in the claw, is that useful for me? It looks like maybe I could do it. It feels doable. Like here, let's just. How do I like? Ooh-yah! Ooh-yah! No. Ooh-yah! There. Oh, so close. What is the point of this? That would roll. Oh, I could stand on that. You see that? That slow roll, actually. Oh, that slow roll is really nice. Look at that slow roll. This is the competition where we learn 900 ways to slow roll a snowball. Now, if there was something there, that might have worked. Maybe a Mecha Koopa? Maybe a Mecha Koopa? Clearly what I need to do is... Here, wait. I get the first step. The first step of the puzzle is that. Okay, there we go. Now we have Mecha Koopa. Mecha Koopa down there. Does this change anything? I think I'm getting this puzzle. Does this change anything? No, that doesn't change that. Oh, whoops. I forgot you can pick up Mecha Koopa. Let's get back in there. Okay, next question. Next question is... I think I'm starting to get this. If I put this there... Please do it, though. Okay. If I put this there, then I do this, and then I do that. Okay, that doesn't really help that. Well, I need to get up there again, don't I? I need to, like... What a weird level. It's like I need the switch to be... hit. And then I need to, like, remote... Oh, if the dude wakes up, it would work. So it's like, I need... This is interesting. It's like I need something to hit this while I'm still up here. Or I need to hit the switch while I'm down here. And then stay down here. Because then this can fall. I think this can fall if I put a Mecha Koopa up here and then it, like, wakes up and then it walks. Maybe? Looks like... reasonable. Do Mecha Koopas follow you? I think they do. Did we figure that out in one of the other levels? But how would I get... Yeet! How would I get the Mecha Koopa up there? This is a really cool puzzle. I like this one. Oh, I can stand on him to get a little height. I can stand on him to get a little height. Does that help? That doesn't really help me. Wait, I can enter the door on him. You can enter a door on a Mecha Koopa, dude! What the heck? You can enter a door on a Mecha Koopa. It's pretty sick. Oh! We're solving the puzzle that we don't even know how! The Mecha Koopa walked this way because I spawned in this door. Wow. Alright, planned. So now the stump is down there. And all we- Oh, but now we need to get- Oh, this is so stupid, though. Now I need to get hit. Oh! Such a tease! Such a tease! It's not solved, because... Could it have fallen on me? If I remote activated the on and off switch, could it have fallen on me? Wait a minute. How am I gonna get hit? Was there a way to get hit through that door? There wasn't, right? I don't think so. I don't think this is cheese. How do you get hit? What is- So the claw has to be for something. What's the claw for? What's the claw for? You can't take a snowball through the door. And I can't get the Mecha Koopa again. Will more Mecha Koopas spawn? What if I take a Mecha Koopa through the door with me? Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Let's try that. What happens if... Now we... Oh, I can't stump now. Oh, but I can snowball. Oh! Wait, no. I'm so... How do I... Get... Is it the... If I could... If I could go in the door like this, maybe it would help me? Can you take an item? No, I don't think you can take steps or anything. Does this kill it? It does kill it. Is that useful? I don't think the... What will the claw catching the shroom do for us? I don't think it does anything for us. Die. 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 Yeah, I want to ride the snowball. That's my point. That's what I'm trying to do. I don't know how. I want to ride the snowball. But it breaks. How do I make Snowball not die? Something like that? Is that a thing? Probably not. It's probably not a thing. We can get Stump. What do we do with Stump? I can't reset now, right? Yeah, it destroys it. How do I get the Stump and use it to do anything useful? The problem that I see is like, well, I don't actually know what would happen, but I imagine that I need to just put the stump here and then get hit, right? Like, all I need to do is put the stump here and get hit. In your hole, please, I think. Huh. Okay, like... What am I doing, though? Hmm? But what does this do for me? What am I doing? What am I doing? What am I doing? This isn't helping. Oh, enter door on the snowball while holding a Mega Koopa. That's what I wanted to do, Shock, and I can't do it. That's exactly what I wanted to do, but I couldn't do it. That's where my brain got tied in a knot. What did Door say? Door knows what we're talking about. Make a snowball and go to the right and hold it and let the Mega Koopa come at you. Wait. Make a snowball and go to the right and hold it and let the Mega Koopa come at you. Okay, this is what I was trying to do when chat told me I was overcomplicating things, by the way, but I was trying to do it right here. I was trying to do it right there. Is it just gonna drop it on the door? No, it doesn't. I thought I was gonna drop it on the door, but it doesn't. Oh, it... It respawns the Mega Koopa and then it goes to the right. It respawns them. When you kill it, it goes the way. Okay, it comes out of the pipe and then walks the other way. Woo! Okay. Yeah, this is so simple. Oh my god, it's like disgusting how simple this puzzle is. And yet, so hard for me to figure out. Okay. You die. Die. You here, you die. Okay, I need him to hit me. I need him to hit me and then... So I think the key is that you both... See, look at that. You get hit and you kill the Mega Koopa at the same time. So... It hits me, but then it dies, but then a new one spawns, and then a new one goes up there. But then I still need some way... Wait, I still need to hit the on and off, right? I still need a way to remote hit the on and off, right? But how do we use the claw now? What was the claw supposed to be doing? What was the claw supposed to be doing? Do we put another snowball here and jump off of it? Oh, we can just jump off. We can literally just jump off of it if we're like that, can't we? Die. 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 Okay. Boom, boom, walk, drop, release the snowball. Boop! Nice, that's what that's for. I thought it was for going in the door. Oh my god. All right, now we go in there and that's the end of the level. It's so simple. Very clever level. Very not clever, Carl. Really cool. I really like that level. It was like, that I got so, I got so stuck down the wrong, in the wrong rabbit hole. It needed a fish at the end. Really good level. Yeah, very simple, but very hard to see how the pieces fit together. This hole confused the shit out of me. This hole, this one hole confused the absolute shit out of me. Did not figure it out. I really like the level though. I also got very confused about going in and out of the door right here without realizing that, like, it's weird. This is like a weird thing where, like, oh, whoops, I didn't even go up there. It's weird because it both acts as a hint and as a red herring at the same time. Because... Whoop. Going in the door on this guy... Like, imagine if you couldn't go back right now. Imagine if you couldn't go back right now. Or there was like a pipe that leads you back to the reset. The nice thing about this is that it shows you, oh, it can spawn and walk the other way and that lowers this. But that... actually hurt me because I thought that that was the only way to do that because I'm an idiot. Because I'm an absolute idiot. And so I didn't think that, like, no, if at any point I spawn a new Koopa over here, then it will walk over here. When I played the first version, it was really easy and I said to make it a bit harder. Then he sent me a version which I didn't, which I got confused and you did like or didn't like. After that, I said, solution is perfect. Just give some thought on how to make the level flow better. And they did listen. It made the level overall very good. This has been a great series of puzzles. Yeah, this whole competition has been really awesome. We're definitely gonna do more of these. I think we'll probably do another one after this. Yeah, that level was really interesting.
The more you know, the more you know, the more you know, the more you know. Knowledge is power, the more you know, the more you know, the more you know, the more you know. The more you know.